We are on the hunt for the perfect 1080p GPU for Star Citizen. The new contenders today are the 3060 and the 4060. Are they a good upgrade over the 2060? How much does each generation improve? I've already tested the 6700 XT from AMD and that was pretty much perfect for 1080p. So how do these NVIDIA cars compare to that? Can these cars even do a job at 1440p? Lots of interesting questions, let's find out. Now, before we focus heavily on these GPUs, let's just do a quick reminder that you probably, most people, should upgrade their CPU first. Unlike most games, SC is massively heavy on the CPU. If you're heavily CPU bottlenecked, upgrading a GPU could be a complete waste of money. If you open up some sort of performance overlay and the GPU is not at 100%, then you're going to be a combo of CPU slash RAM slash engine bound. Ignore what the CPU usage percentage tells you. That's not that helpful when understanding Star Citizen CPU performance. I'll link a couple of videos below looking at CPU performance, but the latest and greatest from AMD and Intel are the best bet if you're looking to buy something new. This testing has been done with a 7800X3D so that most of the time we are GPU bottlenecked, only a couple of occasions where actually the CPU gets in the way. We've got 32 gigs of RAM and the full setup is in the description, so check that out. I'll show you the results of the testing now as I talk through some of my thoughts on this. Let's start with the 2060. So I've tested this before. It's a good upgrade over my minimum spec recommendation, the 1660. And if you're on a real budget and targeting 1080p, it is a genuine option. But as you'd expect, that's now quite an old car and each generation of these 60 series from NVIDIA is better than the last. Looking at the 3060, it's not a massive improvement over the 2060. I was kind of hoping for a little bit more, to be honest. The big pro of the 3060 is that it's got 12 gigs of VRAM. That's absolutely loads for plenty of years to come. But as it was pointed out when this card was first released, the card is only really fast enough for 1080p. So that VRAM doesn't actually end up being that useful that often. Now, I suppose if you pick up a 3060 for a very good price and know that you're going to stick to 1080p for a long time, then it is a decent option. But for 1080p, I much prefer the 4060. It's a decent way ahead in all of this testing. The 4060 and 6700 XT trade blows. Both are pretty perfect for 1080p. They both managed to become mostly CPU bound by the 7800X3D in Lawville. And really, the numbers are looking good in all of this testing. At 1080p, you would be very happy with either of these cards. Both of them can be pushed in service at 1440p. The FPS numbers are not that high, but it would be Star Citizen playable, I think. Depending on the CPU that you've got, it might be quite well matched at 1440p. But the key difference, obviously, is the amount of VRAM these cards have got. The 4060 only has 8 GB, and the 6700 XT has 12. So if you were thinking about running 1440p with one of these cards, you should probably go with the 6700 XT. Long term, 8 GB for the 4060 is probably not going to be ideal for most games at 1440p. In quantum travel, we see this weakness that older AMD cards have with this particular workload, so there might be a case to jump up to a 7700 XT. The 7000 series cope a lot better in quantum travel in my testing, but the 7700 XTs cost a lot more money at this point, and quantum travel and its animations are going to change in the next year anyway. Ray tracing is traditionally an NVIDIA plus point, and we'll have to test that once it arrives in Star Citizen. It is coming, but really at this kind of budget end of things, I don't think we should expect much from any of these cards. I think if your heart is set on ray tracing in Star Citizen, you probably should save up some more money and get a higher tier card. In terms of an upgrade path, well, I don't think the 3060 looks that great compared to the 2060. I think that'll be a pretty disappointing upgrade. I think going from the 3060 to the 4060 does look better, but for me, it still wouldn't be enough to tempt me to put the money down. Again, I think the 6700 XT probably looks like the best option for an upgrade in this price range. The elephant in the room is the used market. I know some people don't like to buy a used GPU, but I think if you're in this sort of budget area, it makes sense to look at it. Secondhand versions of the older cars like the 3060 and the 6700 XT could save you quite a lot of money. And then you also got cars like the 3070, the 2080, maybe the 2080 Ti, and also the 6800 XT that all might be quite good options depending on how cheap you can find them.
Right, this is editing me. I completely forgot to just mention PCIe lane. So
The 3060 and the 4060 both are PCIe Gen 4, but with 8 lanes. Now, that doesn't matter for PCIe 4 because there's no way these cars are going to saturate that amount of bandwidth. But if you only have a motherboard that's capable of PCIe Gen 3, well, then these cars will be running at PCIe Gen 3 with 8 lanes. Now, that potentially could affect performance. I did a quick bit of testing. I couldn't see anything in the very short period of time I did with the testing, but it is a factor. And so just be aware and do some research. If you've got an older motherboard that's only PCIe Gen 3, these cards will not be able to run at the full bandwidth that they should, because NVIDIA being a bit lazy really, or cheaping out and trying to cut down the amount of lanes.
So overall, for me, the 4060 and the 6700 XT are the obvious ones out of this list. I think the 3060 doesn't look like a great option. But hopefully the data that you've seen will allow you to make your own decision. So if you want to chat some of this stuff through, come and join the Discord, because there's lots of people there who are very helpful and will be able to help you out with any upgrade options that you need, especially as we talked about at the start, thinking about what CPU you've got as well. So come and join the Discord, link's in the description.